None went out, and none came in. And the Lord said unto Joshua, See, I have given into thine hand Jericho, and the king thereof, and the mighty men of valor. And he shall compass the city, all ye men of war, and go round about the city once. Thus shalt thou do 6 days. And 7 priests shall bear before the ark 7 trumpets of ram's horns. And the 7th day ye shall compass the city 7 times. The priests shall blow the trumpets. And it shall come to pass that when they make a long blast with the ram's horn, and when ye hear the sound of the trumpet, all the people shall shout with a great shout, and the wall of the city shall fall down flat. And the people shall ascend up, every man straight before him. For the Lord hath said unto Joshua, Shout, for I have given you the city.
The inhabitants of Jericho were perverted by sin and corrupt. Surrounded by a wall so thick, the chariots raced on top. With ladders, catapults, and spearheads ready, and blazing in the sun, the armies of Israel stood waiting for commands of war to come. For 39 years, Joshua was trained under Moses' righteous hand. And it was Joshua who led nearly 3 million Israelites into the promised land. Now Moses was dead, and the real test came. Could he simply follow God's word and do something that to the natural mind would be utterly absurd? Without Moses to ask advice of, or an advisory committee, God said, the walls will fall. Just tell them, shout, for I have given you the city. Now God was putting in operation a principle of war, setting at our disposal weaponry that drops demons to the floor. Something with tremendous power that assassinates fear and doubt. It's the high praises of victory, unleashed by a shout. When David played his songs of praise, demons fled from Saul. As Paul and Silas worshiped God, the chains began to fall. It lifts us above the circumstance and lets God's power flow. The shout of victory binds the devil with chains that won't let go. Confidence of warring angels, Israel stood stone ready to obey Joshua, speak to their mountain, and shout, for God was giving them the city. They look fear dead in its face. They didn't wait to feel some earthquake or to see a lightning flash. They didn't need to hear a theatrical rumble or a mind-blowing crash. They prepared their souls for victory. Now it's God's turn to come through. They'd scream their lungs out simply because they believed God's word was true.
Down and out, and they want to know.
Sid, I dare you to forget the person next to you and trials you've been in. Forget religious do's and don'ts and traditions made of men. And with a shout of victory on your lips, with praise declaring war, to leap upon your feet right now, make a joyful noise.
Of what he